Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of XAMPP on a Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how to write a simple Hello World PHP program and how to run that on our browser. Should you watch the video till the end, I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you still face any issues in middle, you can always comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Now to install latest version of XAMPP, you need to first simply go to favorite browser. And then you need to search over here, XAMPP download, and hit enter. So that's going to show you this download XAMPP. So you need to click on this link, and it's going to automatically redirect to the official site of XAMPP. So this link, this apachefriends.org, I'm going to put right in our description. So you can directly use that link to land over here. And once you are here, you'll be able to see all these different versions of XAMPP is available for Windows. So if you're using some other operating system like Linux or macOS, you can always scroll down and then you can download all these following links. For Windows, you need to just simply get here and then you'll be able to see the latest version is version 8.2.12. So you need to click on this download button and there you go. Awesome. Your download will start automatically. And you can see that our XAMPP is rightly started downloading. You can see it is rightly started. Since I have already downloaded it, so I'll just simply cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory. And here you can see that latest version of XAMPP is already been downloaded over here. So to install, you need to just simply double click on that installer. And that's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes. And you'll be able to see welcome to XAMPP. So click on OK over here. So a XAMPP installation wizard is rightly open. Click on next. So these are all files it's going to install, which is totally fine. Just simply click on next. And this is where our XAMPP is going to be installed. So on our C drive, it's going to create a XAMPP folder, and within that XAMPP folder, it's going to put all the installed files. So just, you know, simply click on next over here. And you can see that our default language is English. If you want to change it with the Dutch, you can always do that, but I'm going to keep it default English, and I'm going to click on next. So now you can see that it is ready to be installed. Just simply click on next and there you go. Welcome to XAMPP, and you can see that it is rightly started installing, right? So this will take some time, you know, about I can say like 4 to 5 minutes. So you can, you know, grab some tea or coffee, and after that you can again come back to this video. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our XAMPP is rightly installed, and also do you want to start the control panel now option is also rightly selected. So you can just simply click on finish to launch our XAMPP control panel, and you can also minimize your this directory. We no longer need this directory, and you can see that our XAMPP control panel is also rightly open. So, you know, we have this Apache and MySQL. So these two are the very important, you know, module that we need to start. So click on start for each of this item like Apache, and then for MySQL also click on start. So that's going to, you know, start both your Apache and MySQL. So all PID are rightly assigned along with the ports. So if you see some issues on starting of these two module, then you can always refer to these two videos. So I'm going to put that also link in the description. So 99% of the cases you should be having both these two starting properly, but if for some reason that is not getting start, so then you can refer to these two video. All right, so once these two get start, you can always click on for MySQL this admin. So that's going to open this localhost phpmyadmin right in our browser. So you can see our phpmyadmin is rightly open. So these are all the database. If you want to create a new database, you can always click on new over here. And you can give your database name. So let's give a database name something like employee DB and click on create. So that's going to create a new database. You can see that our employee DB is rightly created over here, and I can subsequently create a new table and all that you can do. Alright, so if you need a detailed video about how to use phpMyAdmin, how to establish connection with your code with phpMyAdmin, all that, if you need a detailed video, you can always mention. I'm going to make a video about that as well. For now, let's write a simple PHP code snippet. So for that, you need to first go to your C drive and go to XAMPP, and then you need to go inside this htdocs folder. So just, you know, simply double click on that htdocs folder. All right, and within htdocs folder, you need to right click and then you need to, you know, go to new, and then you can create a new folder. And you can give this folder name as PHP dash practice. Alright, and within that folder, I'm going to create a new text document, and I'm going to give this text document name as hello.php. Alright, I'm going to remove this .txt extension. Only I'm going to keep hello.php and click on outside. So do you want to change the file name? Yes. So if for some reason you don't see these file name extensions like .php or .txt, that sort of thing, then you need to go to view and then you need to hover over show and then you need to enable these file name extensions over here. See, we have a tick mark icon, right? So that is enabled. So you need to enable these file name extensions. Once you have that, then you can see this extension after the file name. So you need to open this file in a notepad. And here you can write a simple PHP code snippet. So angular bracket PHP, close that angular bracket, and you can do something like echo hello world, hello world. All right, so just end with a semicolon, go to file and save this file. And now if you go to your browser and open a new tab and just simply type localhost slash and then name of your folder. So we have created this PHP practice folder, right, within htdocs folder. So to go to that folder, so remove this phpmyadmin and just type localhost slash php space practice. Hit enter. So that's going to show you this helloworld.php program that you have created. So if you click on that, you'll be able to see the output hello world rightly shown on our console. Right, you can see the output clearly on our console. So in this way, you can easily create a simple hello world PHP code and you can run that on our browser. You need to install XAMPP. You need to follow this entire video if you face any issues again. I have also started Geeky Syntax channel. So here regularly I'm posting coding related videos. So please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel along with our Geeky Script channel. And also if you're interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. Recently, I am posting a lot of videos on WordPress, so I have posted one video about how to create a portfolio website or e-commerce store or even a gym website. So all this, you know, complete video you will get on this playlist. So if you are interested, you can also watch this entire, you know, playlist. So you'll get a lot of videos, 55 minute video or smaller video, all this you'll get on this playlist. Right, so do follow our channel and learn more about WordPress. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.